Boris Johnson's hosting the biggest climate conference in the world. One of his main priorities? Get rid of coal for good.
Our country, the UK, was 40% reliant on coal to generate power. Today it's only 1%.
But just 2 hours' drive south of Glasgow, one town is threatening to spoil Johnson's party by welcoming coal back. An international company wants to open the first new coal mine in decades here in Whitehaven, Cumbria.
In the 1950s, coal was still our dominant energy source.
But when the mines became unprofitable in the 1980s, the government shut them down. That hit towns like Whitehaven hard.
Loads and loads of mines all got shut down, and it's just slaughtered this county.
For people here, the new mine is a chance to turn things around.
I would estimate around about 90% of the people are in favour of the mine. It's got very, very, very strong support in the local community.
This is where the mine is supposed to be built. It used to be the site of a major chemical plant that, when it closed in 2005, left this big empty space and a huge hole in the local economy.
But the plans have horrified environmentalists who say it's taking Britain in the wrong direction.
The climate impact is quite clear. It's 9 million tonnes of carbon dioxide a year reaching the atmosphere that wouldn't do otherwise.
It's even prompted criticism from politicians in the US.
I think, generally speaking, the marketplace has made a decision that coal is not the future.
The mine's biggest selling point is that it will only produce coking coal, used to produce steel, rather than burning it for energy, which is dirtier. Supporters say that if coal wasn't mined here, the UK would have to import it anyway.
So when I came in...
John Fell is a chef and one of several local business people who's trying to turn the town around. We sat down with some of them to hear why they felt the mine was misunderstood.
But the building that you're sitting in now has been designed as a carbon neutral, a carbon neutral building. You know, so it's not like the community are not thinking this way.
This is not a decision about whether we use coking coal or not. We are using coking coal. This is a discussion about where it comes from, not whether we use it.
But Whitehaven isn't alone. As the world transitions to a zero carbon future, governments will have to decide whether communities like this win or lose. For the news, I'm Matt Bradley.